If you'd like fresh, delicious lettuce all year long from your indoor garden, we're going to show you how to use the Kratky method along with Happy Leaf LED lights on how to do that. So what you need in order to start growing is you need a large mouth canning jar. You need some hydroponic clay pellets. You need a 3-inch diameter net pot. You need some nutrients. We recommend the Maxi Grow from General Hydroponics as a really good starting nutrient. So the other thing you need is a high quality LED light. And we also do recommend a timer. And the purpose of the timer is to be able to turn the light on and off whenever you want to. We typically recommend on for about 16 to 18 hours a day. So you also need a black sock and you need some seeds. So you need to figure out what kind of lettuce you'd like to grow. I've got two lettuces here in front of me. This one's called Mosquera, and this is called Red Romaine. And these both come from Seed Savers. This is actually a Seed Saver packet. The one I have here is called Yugoslavian Red Butterhead. So lettuce actually can grow in cooler places. So there's no problem in growing in most people's basements. But it also does fine up to about 75 to 80 degrees. If you get much above that, you could start bolting. So I would say a good temperature range is somewhere between 50 and 75 degrees, which is what the temperatures are in most of our homes. From there, we're going to start growing lettuce using the Kratky method, which is a method developed by Dr. Bernie Kratky from the University of Hawaii. But the method is ingenious in that it allows you to grow in canning jars. So it's done completely passively. There's no pumps, there's no motors, there's no electricity other than using the light. And we're gonna show you how to set that up and get lettuce that looks like this in about 4 weeks. So you fill the net pot with the clay pellets, and then you take your canning jar and a gallon of water, and I mix a teaspoon of nutrients in there. So you only need a teaspoon. It comes with a little measuring container. So you put a teaspoon in there and mix it up really well with your spoon. And now you've got a gallon of nutrient water. So now I take this and I fill it with nutrient water up to this little ledge here. So now I've got water right there. And now what I do is I basically take the net pot with the clay pellets and put it into here. And you'll notice that the water level basically comes up to the top. So the clay pellets are wet. The next thing I do is actually screw on a lid, which I do not have here with me. And then the next step is to take my seeds. I usually take 5 to 7 seeds, and I will take off the top layer of pellets and then sprinkle them along around the perimeter onto the wet clay pellets. So now they are wet. And now I put the clay pellets on top. Now, what I do just before I put it under the light is I take the sock, I stretch it, put it over the jar, and these are just basically black tube socks. And the purpose of the sock is to prevent algae growth. Then you turn your light on. This is a Procyon 2.0 light. I usually have it set to be on for 16 to 18 hours a day. And you're up typically 10 to 12 inches up above the plant. You can actually put up to 24 jars under one of these lights on the baker's rack, and suddenly you have your indoor garden. This is what the roots look like after a few weeks. This particular lettuce has been growing for about 3.5 weeks. So you could see they drop, and you could see that the water level now is within about 1.5 inches of the bottom. So that means that we've absorbed that much water over the life of the plant. So for the first 3 to 4 weeks, you do not have to add any water into this plant. And then when you do add water, which is usually in about 4 weeks, you can pour water directly into the root area, and then you will see the water level come up, but never fill it above the bottom of the net pot. The reason that Bernie figured out that this method works really well is that the roots get their oxygen through this area in the root system. And he calls them oxygen roots, actually. And that's what makes this so ingenious, because there's no pumps, there's no motors, and there's no electricity. Will lettuce regrow is the question. And the answer is yes. Lettuce is basically like grass. It'll keep regrowing. But what we have found is more than 2 to 3 cuttings, many of the lettuces start becoming bitter. So how do you harvest your lettuce? This lettuce is actually ready to be harvested. And what you can do is you can either just snip off the bigger leaves around the perimeter, or you can use scissors. So you could take a pair of scissors, just like you have at home, and snip off around the perimeter. Or if you have a family event and you want to have more lettuce, you could literally just take the top of it and cut it off completely and have a nice big salad. It will regrow. It may not grow as big the second time, but within a couple of weeks, you'll actually have a second harvest of lettuce. If you're ready to start your own indoor garden, visit happyleafled.com. Please subscribe and like our channel and discover the joy of growing indoors all year long.